Let's have a look at how we can group things together using connectors and lines in Freeform. That means that you can then position things wherever you like, and the connectors will stay in place. So we're going to press the Shapes button at the top of our screen. And the very first three options are a straight line, an arrow, and a curved line. Now the straight line and the arrow behave in the same way. And if I grab one of those, I can very quickly position the start and the end, and I can even change the style of the arrow to make it thicker, change the arrowhead, or change the colour. However, this arrow is a static object. It's not going to change and adapt as your board grows. So my advice to you is to go back onto that shape option and choose the curved line. This has got a blue dot at each end and a green dot in the middle. And as soon as you pick up and move one of those blue dots, it will clip on to a nearby object. So I can grab one end and I can clip it onto my shopping subtitle, and I can grab the other end and clip it onto my sticky note. Now that green dot in the middle, I can use that to change the shape of my line to make it longer or more curvy. And of course, I can change the properties of the line as well to make it thicker, to make it a dotted or a dashed line, and to change the colour. I can also change if I want it to be a curved line or a straight line at this point too. Finally, I can add an arrowhead or a dot or a marker at either the start or the end of my line, so I can customise it to exactly what I want. But the best part is when I move my sticky note, the line will automatically move as well and reroute itself around your content. I'm going to copy and paste this line and connect up lots of other things, but you don't need to watch me do that. Instead, hop over to the next video where I'll show you how to embed rich URLs and insert documents into a freeform board. I'll see you there in a moment.